The U.S. is grappling with the deadliest outbreak of bird flu in history. But why has it spread so quickly, and how is that going to affect our health and our wallets? To answer some of these questions, I'm joined by PBS NewsHour correspondent William Brangham. William, thank you for joining me.
Great to be here, Nicole, as always.
So how long has bird flu or avian flu been an issue?
Well, birds carry flu in their stomachs all the time. There are millions of flu viruses circulating amongst birds, and most of the time it never causes a problem, either for them or for us. But every now and then, one of those viruses becomes super contagious amongst birds and becomes deadlier to birds, and that's what we are going through right now. So this virus, which is known as H5N1, has been circulating for quite a few years, but only recently, in the last couple of years, the last year and a half, really, has it taken off and has just been killing birds, domestic birds, wild birds. I mean, I was in a bird sanctuary in Minnesota, and they were seeing what are called raptors, eagles, owls, falcons, hawks, even those types of birds, getting this virus and dying from it. So, I mean, as one flu researcher who I talked to recently said, this is a very, very bad time to be a bird right now. So it is causing a lot of problems.
And for farmers, farmers in the U.S. have either lost or had to kill more than 58 million birds to prevent the spread of this virus, which begs the question, you know, how has this affected the consumption and production of chickens and eggs here in the U.S.?
Well, just as you're saying, Nicole, it's a nightmare for farmers, I think is the technical term for it. It is farmers that produce eggs or chickens or turkeys for eating have to do an enormous amount of what's called biosecurity. And so that is basically just every time you go in and out of the barn, you have to disinfect your shoes, you have to disinfect your gloves, you often have to wear a mask, and you have to be hypervigilant for any outbreak. I mean, I don't know if anyone has seen what it looks like on a chicken or a turkey farm, but there are these massive buildings where thousands, sometimes tens of thousands of birds are kept together. And if the flu gets into one of those contained facilities, the flu can spread like wildfire. And so then they would have to kill the entire flock. That number that you described, that nearly 60 million birds that have died, most of those are not because they got infected, but because they were living amongst a much smaller number that did get infected. And so that to stop the spread, they have to kill the entire flock. So if flu appears inside one of these big barns, they kill all the birds inside there. So it's driven up egg prices. It's raised the general anxiety level amongst people worrying. They're seeing all these headlines about this bird flu surging across the country. So again, it is causing lots of downstream consequences.
Does anyone who eats chicken or eggs need to worry about getting bird flu from eating chickens and eggs that might have it?
No, that is a real concern. And all the evidence that is out there right now is that cooking properly, your chicken or eggs or turkey, whatever poultry product you're eating, if you cook it to the appropriate temperature, you're not going to get the bird flu. Also, farmers are doing a very good job of culling their flock so that the idea of bird flu ending up in the food supply right now, there's really no evidence that that is happening. But if you're concerned, just do smart food safety practices. Cook your eggs, cook your chicken, cook your turkey, really wash the boards that you're using with those, wash your hands. Again, just smart, basic kitchen practices will prevent anything like that from happening.
And as we think about this element of transmissibility, is bird flu transmissible to humans and should we be worried?
Another epidemiologist that I was in touch with said that as a general person, she was not alarmed. But as an epidemiologist, she was. And the concern is this, which is right now, there are very, very rare cases of this bird flu jumping into humans. It's happened, I think it's a few hundred times in the last year or so. It has unfortunately killed nearly half those people who did get the bird flu. But those are very rare cases. And those are almost always cases where someone was directly in touch with birds that were infected or dealing with their feces or their excrement. And so they got a big dose of that flu and it made them sick. And half of those people died on average. What has not happened yet, and this is what everybody is really looking out for, is that for every one of those individuals that got sick with the bird flu, they did not pass the virus to other humans, because that would be a sign that the virus had evolved from its ability to spread wildly amongst birds now to jump into humans and become contagious amongst humans. That would be a pull the fire alarm, truly alarming development. That was what most of the pandemics, COVID excepted, that has been the circumstances where we have had major pandemics that have killed millions of people. The 1918 flu was another one of these avian flus, jumped into humans, became contagious amongst humans, and took out huge chunks of the global population of human beings. So they're looking out for that. There's occasional cases that seem to pop up that they investigate quite closely. But so far, there are no known cases of it spreading amongst humans, just those individualized cases. But that is something that the public health community, researchers, and epidemiologists all over the world are looking out for and are really worried about, because the more of this bird flu that spreads, the more interactions you have on farms and places all over the country and all over the world where humans are interacting with birds that might be sick, giving that virus more of a chance to possibly replicate. But so far, the CDC, the WHO have said there are nothing to really worry about with regards to human health yet. Hope it stays that way.
One of the other questions here is that we have seen some reporting that the Biden administration considered a vaccine for chickens. Is there a potential cure for this virus?
There is no cure for the virus, but there are some vaccines that have been manufactured that they believe might work in chickens or turkeys or other domestic birds. The problem is none of those vaccines have been approved by the regulators that regulate these. And there's some resistance within the farming community to do that. And the reason for that is that if you start to vaccinate birds here, I mean, there's a huge number of chickens, especially, that get exported to countries all over the world. It's a big multi-billion dollar market in the United States. Farmers are saying that if they start vaccinating their birds, a lot of their foreign buyers will not buy those birds. And so if you potentially dent a multi-billion dollar industry, you can understand why chicken manufacturers in particular are alarmed at that idea. So you know, chickens and turkeys get vaccinated for all sorts of things, but if you vaccinate for this particular virus, it's a complicated issue, but it could then show up as a trace element in that chicken later, and other nations don't want to import American birds that have that. So that is a big concern, but as this pandemic amongst the birds continues to spread, you might see more calls for that, because all the public health researchers I've talked to said you've got to do something to try to keep this incredible spread amongst birds to a minimum. Vaccination may be a step in that direction, but it's not happening just yet.
What we do know is that time will tell, and that you have given us more insight than we had before. So William Brangham, PBS NewsHour correspondent, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure, Nicole. Always great to see you.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nicole Ellis.